So I posted a video the other day on how to convert your power windows to manual on your E36, and I just wanted to go back and update it a little bit. I said you could buy a $40 window regulator and it would work fine, which is true. I mean, you can get them. Right now they're up a little bit higher than when I bought mine, so you might be looking for more like $60, including shipping and everything. But there are still like dirt cheap ones from, far away, whatever. But another option would be like any basically older BMW regulator, I believe should work. This one came off of an E21, and I think I paid like $25 for it, shipped, like free shipping, everything, so super easy. Here in the States, it only takes a few days. But my only concern is these are slightly different. This part is three pieces instead of one. This pin comes out, and then the gear comes off. Gear snaps in pretty well, so like that's not too concerning. But this pin, I'm slightly worried that once it's all together, that like somehow if this pin worked its way off, it would screw up. I think the way it's in the regulator, it should stop that from happening. But if you wanted to try it, it's, like I said, $25 or so. You can get it instead of paying 40 plus shipping and having to wait. But just keep in mind, it might not work as well as the OEM E36 one. And then I also mentioned that the window cranks from like Amazon should work. I actually don't think they will. This part on here sits a little recessed, and it would actually need to poke out of the door for the Amazon ones to work. So I'm sure there probably are certain options, but I would stick to the OEM E36 cranks. So what you're gonna end up getting is this. $4 gets you a manual window regulator. Clearly, this is a rear, it's not going to fit in the front. But you get this piece off of it, and this will make it work. This came from the factory in here like so. There's four little rivets. You drill out the rivets and you have this now. This is garbage. Throw this away. You don't have any use for it. This is the key piece. This will let your windows go up and down with this little knob right here. But when you hit a bump or you push down on it, whatever you do, your window will not creep down at all. There's four pieces to it. There is this part that has a spring in it. This spring is super important. Don't take it out. This part actually is going to bolt to your window regulator. This piece is just like the door handle. It's kind of got like a goofy shape. It ends up sliding into here. Like so. And once that's in properly, you see it? You can turn it. It's not easy, it's pretty hard because you don't have the leverage on it like you normally would with the actual handle, but it spins. You put in, there's a little spring, you drop that right down on there, like so, and then that slides in on there. When you turn this gear, it's stuck. It will not budge. You turn the handle part and it spins. And that's because I think basically the spring is trying to, the way it's in there, the spring is kind of trying to expand when you turn on the gear. And that just kind of like freezes the spring up in place, I guess. So when you get a push on your window or if you hit a bump, it's not budging, unlike my current setup. So yes, this is all you need. You don't probably don't really need to know how it works. All you need to know is this is what you need. The next thing you're going to do is remove your old regulator. Usually there's the like rivets in over here, but I've already changed this one, so I just replaced them with nuts and bolts. There's plenty of videos online on how to do that, so just pull your regulator off real quick. Once the regulator is off, you're going to want to remove these three torques, which I've already loosened. And once they are off, you can remove the motor. So here's a little side-by-side comparison. The gear on the motor is clearly much bigger than the manual part, but this still works. You basically just stick it in there and push it as far over as possible, and then you're gonna just use these holes to, like there's these four holes in here, and I just use them to basically drill holes. So it'll end up kind of sitting like this. I put this first bolt in and the nut, I tightened it up. Clearly it doesn't sit flush, but I mean it works. And then I kind of tap this over just to force it as far over as I can to make sure it grabs as many teeth as possible on that gear. And then I
drill my second hole.
Once you drill the hole, take it back out, clean all this up real good, and then re-grease inside of here before you put it back on.
I only use two nuts, two bolts. Once everything's all nice and tight, it's, you know, it's not going anywhere. It's held in well. It's forced up against the gears inside of here all the way. And it's all ready to be installed again.
So I switched sides real quick, but this kind of just shows the whole finished assembly and how it, you know, cranks. It's nice and solid, but also when you push down on it, you know, it's not going anywhere.
This is all kind of just back together. The hole here, I just need to clean it up a little bit. One thing I did to get that hole in the right spot was I popped out the speaker. And when you pop out the speaker, it can kind of give you like a better view of the inside just to make sure you kind of drill that right hole. And then I still, even once I drilled the hole, I didn't have any bits big enough for that. I kind of just had to like use a razor and kind of clean it out a little bit. But this is all functional now. It's nice and solid. It's a little hard to turn right now, but I think it'll probably get easier. There you go.